The average person doesn't think about this. Where does the food come from? How does it even get to the supermarket? On an 18-wheeler tractor trailer. These truckers are at the forefront of our food supply. It's very simple. In order to transport food from farms to processing facilities and then to supermarkets, massive amounts of transportation infrastructure is required. Problem is, every single major highway is blanketed with these new 5 grams towers. I made a video on this a few months back discussing how people are getting radiated whenever they travel. It was bad enough with, you know, the 4 grams, the cell phones, the Wi-Fi devices, but now driving back and forth from upstate New York to Pennsylvania to visit farms, I notice these towers every 2 miles or so. You cannot escape. They're on every piece of roadway you can imagine. For the average person, it's an issue, and I get headaches whenever I go on the highway now. But if our truckers are getting radiated 24/7, we're going to have a major issue. Sick with you know what, a trucking team shares their story. Back in March, when there was a great deal of uncertainty about what was going on in the world, a pair of Kansas City-based lease operators became sick while on the road. Now, I already find this very unusual, that they contracted this on the road. It's unlikely given that truckers have little to no human interaction, they get gas at the pump, order fast food through drive-thrus, but let's take that at face value that they did get sick. They survived, but both still suffer recurrent symptoms, despite a clean bill of health from their doctor. Chris still has chest and joint pain and no sense of smell. Shantae still has gastrointestinal issues and fatigue, and her blood sugar and cholesterol levels fluctuate wildly. Let me get this straight. They got sick, recovered, but they're still suffering recurring symptoms. If you're still suffering symptoms, that means you did not recover. Just like if we're locked inside our homes like rats, there can't be a second lockdown because the first one never stopped. Those specific symptoms are identical to radiation sickness. And what is happening to these truckers on the road? They're getting radiated like never before because all of these towers are set up pointed at the road. What confirms this to me is the media says you can get sick from this more than once. Study confirms it's possible to get sick twice. August 24th, 2020, researchers in Hong Kong say they've confirmed that the person can be infected twice. There have been sporadic accounts on social media sites of people who said they've gotten sick twice, but scientists have been skeptical in that possibility, saying there's no evidence it happens. This new proof comes from a 33-year-old man in Hong Kong who first caught it in March. He was tested after he developed a cough, sore throat, fever, and headache for 3 days. He stayed in the hospital until he twice tested negative in mid-April. 33-year-old man, that's a coincidental number. So the first trucker suffered from chest and joint pain as well as no sense of smell, both proven symptoms from the radiation poisoning. You know, radiation causes so much inflammation, it can trigger autoimmune diseases that result in joint pain. And many people report no sense of smell after radiation therapy. The second trucker had gastrointestinal issues, fatigue, fluctuating blood sugar and cholesterol, a result of liver and pancreatic dysfunction due to organs being under incredibly high oxidative stress levels from that radiation. And the 33-year-old man who got sick twice, if he ever existed, has illness symptoms that are identical to this radiation poisoning. Every single side effect listed of you know what is not just similar to radiation poisoning, it is identical, exact same symptom. And we were facing a trucking crisis back in 2018 before this even happened. Not many people wanted to live that lifestyle despite making $80,000 per year. It's hard to say if these companies just aren't offering enough money or if people are too comfortable sitting at home on unemployment. Perhaps it is that on-the-road lifestyle that is not desirable for most people. You know, we've had issues trucking products around for Frankie's Free Range Meat. You know, as simple as buying cardboard boxes to send our products out in, you know, we're paying out our ass thousands of dollars just to ship a trailer across a few states. So trucking companies are getting a premium for their services as there is a huge demand with little supply. There's definitely a few people fear-mongering about the food supply, more empty grocery store shelves, trying to keep people in this negative mindset, but those people are controlled opposition. They want to keep you in fear, constant panic. It's important to stay positive, put your focus on something you enjoy, that you aspire to, and don't get sucked into that negativity, which is exactly what they want. The focus here has to be on understanding that these psychos in control do everything intentionally. If they're radiating truck drivers, travelers on highways, you know, maybe they do plan on a crisis, then they're going to use that to implement self-driving trucks, self-driving cars, who knows what they have in store. You know, we spoke about the Great Reset last Friday. We understand what the end goals are. We have ideas about the components of what they can do to get there, but there is no certainty on precisely how they are going to do it. All we can do is make as many people as aware as possible of what's going on and exposing these little tidbits here and there, like the stuff on highways, the truckers, it gives people some sense to put things together. So thank you guys for joining me today. Let me know how you like this video. If you could please leave a comment down below, drop a like on the video, and above all, if you can, please share the video on social media. If you do want to support me further, you can check out frank-defano.com for everything I have available. You guys enjoy the rest of your day. I'll see you for tomorrow's video. Thank you.